I cannot wait to show you this deck. This is an update of my rank 5 Cyber Dragons, the more competitive version of Cyber Dragons. You can still play the Power Bond build, and if you guys want me to, I will also update that Power Bond build. But this is more of a combo-licious, you know, go seconds deck, whereas, you know, Power Bond, the Power Bond Cyber Dragon OTK is an OTK go second deck. It's not really a combo deck. It's a Power Bond, Summon Out Rampage, and Win deck, which is just fine. It's a really great win condition, especially because no one's playing Battle Traps right now, which is how the Grin Maju the Isaac deck is, you know, working and winning and stuff right now. But I just wanted to do this deck. I wanted to show you guys this deck profile, the rank 5 deck, because I have really worked on it. I have tried really hard to modernize it and make it to be able to play through hand traps, even going second and all that stuff. And I really hope that you guys enjoy it. There's a lot to talk about here. I mean, and a lot to talk about, so try to keep up. I'm going to try to explain this deck, you know, the best that I can so that you guys, you know, all you Cyber Dragon players out there that watch my channel, you know, and keep up with the Cyber Dragon deck builds that I do. I'm going to try to explain this, you know, like I said, just the best that I can so that you can win at Yu-Gi-Oh! And not just win at Yu-Gi-Oh! Win at Yu-Gi-Oh! Playing Cyber Dragons. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and get into this. Okay, so of course, this is going to start off standard, your 3 Cyber Dragons and your 3 cores. But those are the only Cyber Dragons in the main deck, guys. I mean, it's really sad that in today's day and age, to make this deck competitive and to make it go fast and be able to keep up with everything, you have to cut out, like, all other Cyber Dragon cards except for the core. You know, the core and the Cyber Dragons. It's so sad. I mean, dry is just too slow. Its drawback, you know, to where you can only summon machines, really holds you back, especially playing the Brilliant Engine and just everything else that you have to play in this deck to be able to play through hand traps and be able to, you know, get your combos off and everything that you do. So guys, this is it for the Cyber Dragon lineup, but it's just fine. The rest of the lineup is the same. You play your 3 Galaxy Soldiers and your 3 Golden Jets. I feel like this is standard for like every single Cyber Dragon deck now. I feel like I've helped make the standard for every single Cyber Dragon deck. The dry, I mean, I'm gonna be honest, guys, I tried to force dry in there so much to be able to, you know, say that it's more of a Cyber Dragon deck to be, and plus, like, you know, having that extra name for Kaijus and stuff is pretty great when you do have it, and when you do have that really bad hand where you want that extra name, but the situation, like, hardly ever comes up. I just cut it completely, you know, and having the name in the graveyard, like, if you pitch it off a Galaxy Soldier to make, you know, Repair Plant live, that was kind of cool, too, but it's just bad. It's, like, neither a starter or an extender in the deck, and that's what I tried to make this deck. I boiled this deck down to starters, extenders, and cards that get you there, and since dry does really kind of none of those anymore, you know, with the drawback and everything, I just kind of had to cut it from the deck. But what is a starter is Cosmic Compass. This card is ridiculously good. It starts you off going second. It starts you off right going second, because this, you know, the goal of the starters is to get you to a Link monster, and the goal of the extenders is to make Infinity and do everything else, you know, to do your Cyber Dragon moves, to be able to win with your Cyber Dragon moves, because Infinity is a crazy strong card, Durindal is a crazy strong card, Palladium is still a crazy strong card. You can win with those cards, but you just need to be able to make Link monsters to get there with Master Roll 4, and Cosmic Compass really helps with that. It's just such a great card, and on top of that, like, I was really tempted to keep, like, to play Mrs. Radiant and stuff, but really, with all the room I had to make in the extra deck and the way you have to play this card, it's kind of weird. There's actually no room in the extra deck for Firewalls or anything. I could see where this deck could be, you know, a crazy kind of Firewall spam deck after playing out hands and stuff. I could definitely see the potential, especially with this card to be, you know, some sort of Firewall spam deck, but it's just not there, especially because I don't own Firewalls. Plus, it makes it even less of a Cyber Dragon deck than it already is. So, Cosmic Compasses, though, guys, it's a great starter card. Galaxy Soldier is an extender. Core is an extender or a starter. It's a starter with, you know, your machine duplication, of course, because it gets you to, you know, Cyber Dragons. It's just so good, so good. But it's also an extender because this searches out your search card, and your search card gets you to Galaxy Soldier, which is your extender. Golden Jets and extender. I mean, you see where I'm going with this. It's like make Link monsters and then get out, you know, more stuff. It's pretty much how the deck goes. It's pretty much like how every deck is these days. Starters and extenders. I mean, that's really what it comes down to. But you have all of this stuff. So you have your Kaiju engine. You have to have your Kaiju engine. The reason why I still play 2 Jizakiru is because, like, I was back and forth about cutting this card to 1. But why I didn't ever cut it to 1 is because if I were to cut it to 1, it'd be for a Cyber Repair Plant, but you don't always have a Cyber Dragon in Grave with, like, only six Cyber Dragon monsters, as sad as that is. That's really what it comes down to, is, like, if I swap this out for a 3rd Repair Plant, right, that Repair Plant's has a chance of being dead versus Jizakiru, you know, not only it being a kaiju and being useful, but it's also, you know, a monster, you know, if I draw two kaijus, I can kaiju my opponents and then, you know, drop this on my side of the field. And it's also a light for galaxy soldiers. So just all around, in my opinion, Jizakiru is a better card over the third cyber repair plants. Like, basically, I put in the third cyber repair plants when I can't decide what else to put in this deck. Like, if the deck, you know, has a spot and I've already put Upstart in there, then I add the third cyber repair plant back. That's really what it comes down to when it comes to my Cyber Dragon decks, at least this version of the deck. The Power Bond version of the deck, I always play three repair plant because you want your Cyber Dragons, because you, like, there's nothing worse than having that Power Bond and not having any Cyber Dragons to go with it. It's just terrible. It's like the worst thing in the world. So that is, like, you know, the main monster lineup. If you guys don't really get it yet, I will show you guys in the combos. I always do combos, you know, at least I try to always do combos in my deck profiles. So I'll show you guys in the combos. But for the rest of the monsters, you play one Gofu because it's just a one card play. It's a one card decode talker. So it's a starter. It's just a really good starter card. Maxi gets you there. You draw a million cards. And then Garnet just kind of gets you there at Brilliant Fusion. I mean, the brickiest hands you can have with this deck really are, you know, when you draw this and like two Brilliant Fusion. That's like kind of when you lose. Or if you draw, you know, like all three of your machine duplications with like, you know, no targets in hand. That's really, other than that, I feel like the deck is really, really consistent. Just pile shuffle every single game, like every single game, and try not to draw. Just will yourself not to draw this thing, and usually you do pretty well. So for the spells, speaking of Brilliant Fusion, you have to play your three Brilliant Fusions, because just getting that second normal summon plus a Cyber Dragon in the graveyard, guys, oh, it's so good. Like, you never know how bad you want that Cyber Dragon in the graveyard until you have that repair plant in hand, you know what I mean? And you want that Galaxy Soldier, and you can't search it, you know, because you don't have a Cyber Dragon in the grave, and like you don't have enough monsters for a, you know, for a Link monster to be able to get the Cyber Dragon in the grave. Like, this just fixes all of that. Like, Brilliant Fusion is just it's so good. It's just so good, guys. Like, even though you brick with us sometimes, it's just so worth it. It's so worth it. You have to play three machine duplication, especially now but that we have six targets in the deck. It makes it way better. Like, I like having six targets in the deck. I mean, it's before, I'm not gonna lie, guys, it kind of sucked being, you know, drawing two of this and like no target. It really, really sucked, but like you just had to play three of this and the three core because it's like the strongest play in the deck. You know what I mean? It's still one of the strongest plays in the deck, but you know, having the Cosmic Compass for another target is just great. And then I'm playing a really spicy rank one that extends your combos. At least it helps extend your combos, or tries to help extend your combos. Can't wait to show you that. But speaking of extending combos, you have to play your three Insta Fusion, because this is a great extender. Great extender, because I mean, you just get to, you open up a zone with Decode Talker, and then you just keep going, like instant fuse, you know what I mean? Summon a normal summon like Golden Jet and just go, you know, go make a Nova and just keep going. That's why you play three of this. I mean, sometimes it sucks to draw two of this too, but like you have to max out like three ofs on everything to make sure that you do see it in your opening hand, because it's so necessary to be able to play through everything, be able to bait out cards. Plus, this plays around like Ash Blossom. This is like, these two like are good, both of these are really good bait for Ash Blossom. You just have to, like, depending on your hand, you just have to decide which one you want to activate first to try to bait out the Ash. But that's it for the three ofs on the spells. I play two repair plant, you know, because what I was saying earlier, it's just, to me, it's just more live at two in this build. And then two desires, because this fixes really dead hands. It really does. Plus, like, it's really great when you activate this thing and then get your Brilliance out and your Garnet. It's just... It's really great. It's really relieving. And I can't tell you how many times that's happened to me where, like, I'll go desires and be like, please don't draw Brilliant. You know what I mean? Please don't draw Garnet. And then, like, all of them will be banished, and I'll, like, rip into cards that I need, and I'm like, sweet! It's just awesome. Like, and there's just not better cards to play, you know what I mean? And I don't know. Desires is just desires, guys. I mean, what other card can you play? Like, what other spell can you play to get you there? And that goes into what I was saying, guys. Like, I mean, this whole deck, I tried to make it, you know, just go, you know what I mean? Like, starters, extenders, just keep trying to push and play through things, and this helps you get there. It just really does. Speaking of fixing brick hands and helping you get there, though, okay, Soul Charge. So Soul Charge, I mean, you can get hand trapped to death or whatever and just, like, lose out and have everything in the graveyard and then Soul Charge it all back, and this just fixes crap hands. It's so good. This card brings you back From the depths, it really does. Like, Soul Charge is an amazing card. Plus, it is a combo extender if you go first and stuff. It's just so good. Or even going second. Like, it's just a combo extender. You know, just go and, like, out all of your opponent's stuff. And then, I play a Slumber because this is kind of a starter. Because, especially if you have, like, the Chimera Tech play and all that stuff, which you usually always do in this deck in some form or another between, you know, regular, you know, between them. Because we have two Chimera Techs now. We can, like, contact fuse two ways now because we have, like, you know, the old school Chimera Tech, you know, where you just cure your opponent's monster, or in this case, you know, Slumber, like, nuke the field and then give your opponent a Jizakiru, give yourself another Kaiju, and then summon a Cyber Dragon, and then, you know, just go into a Chimera Tech that way. But then we have the Mega Fleet, which is also really, really good. But, yeah, this card it's your nuke, and it just goes, like, it just helps you just kind of, like, you know, especially if you go in second, it just helps you play through. Plus, this is an amazing Ash bait. Like, if you open up, like, Brilliant and this, like, activate the Slumber first, because when you activate the Slumber, they have to Ash this, you know what I mean? Unless their monsters don't care. Like, they have to, like, Ash this or something, and then when they do, just go Brilliant Fusion and go to town. Like, this is really great Ash bait. I love playing this card in the main. You're like, you can't, I feel like at this point, like, Cyber Dragons, are, like, and Kaijus are tight at the hip, because the more I try to replace Kaijus and stuff in the deck, the more I realize that the deck needs Kaijus to be able to play through stuff, you know, because the cards just keep getting better and better, and the Kaijus just, it's just so good. I love this card. I love the Kaijus. I wish this card was still at 3. This card, just, it's too good, though. But then, you also play the Kaijus because of reasoning. Because, you know, you're playing Cyber Dragons. They call 5, you know, and then you hit a Jizakiru and get a free 3,300. Not just that, like, that is really good, but not just that, but they'll call 5 or something, or 4 if they don't know what you're playing, like, they don't know you're playing Cyber Dragons yet, and then you'll rip out, like, you'll have, like, a Machine Dupe in hand, and you'll hit a core, and this will get you to that core, or that Cosmic Compass, and it's just so good. Like, Reasoning is, like, my spicy tech in the deck. I'm so glad that I added this to the deck forever ago and started playing it, because this has just, like, saved so many hands. The Slumber saved a lot of hands, too. Foolish Burial actually saves you some hands. Like, not only is, like, this your fourth Cyber Dragon core going second, basically, because, you know, you banish core and then go for, you know, core for core, Machine Dupe, you know, etc. But, like, this card just, like, gets you a Cyber Dragon in the grave. Like, it serves the purpose. It's like a fourth Brilliant Fusion and a fourth Cyber Dragon core, if that makes sense. Like, Foolish Burial can just fix your hands. It's just so good. And then, like, for the 40th card, the final card, I just played Upstart. I just added Upstart in here. And the only reason why I'm playing Upstart is because I don't feel like drawing two Desires in a hand. So I'm playing two Desires and one Upstart. And it's just, like, I feel like I'm onto something. I feel like this is just the perfect ratio of spells. That's just my opinion, though. For the extra deck, let's start with the standard lineup of cyber monsters. You have your 2 Nova and your 2 Infinity. Your Infinity that takes anything, negates anything, and then your Nova that gets you to it, and your Nova that's, like, your big play extender. Like, Cyber Dragon Nova might be my favorite extra deck monster of all time, guys. It's just so good. Like, this thing OTKs, it floats. I think I say this every single profile, but it's so good. Like, you know, you just make this thing and then summon out a Cyber Dragon from your grave, you know, then get out another level 5 and just make another Nova and just extend. It just goes. Like, this card just helps you just push and just keep going, and if it gets solemned or anything, like, destroyed, it floats out into, you know, Panzer Dragon, and you can just, like, keep extending that way too, like, if you haven't used your instant fusion, that is. But yeah, it's just fantastic. I love this ratio. It's the best ratio Cyber Dragons to play. Pleiades, like, you have to play your Pleiades as standard, you know, 2 level 5 lights, your Cyber Dragons are lights, you know. Plus, like, it's just so broken being able to Kaiju your opponent and then bounce the Kaiju back to your hand. It's just an amazing interaction, and it's just so good. It's so trolly, it's so good. And then for the last thing that you guys are used to seeing, besides, you know, the fusions and everything, you gotta play your Artifact of Rendal, because this unbricks your hands. It unbricks your hands, plus, you know, it screws up your opponent, gives you another negate on your opponent's turn, because you'll have, like, a dead Brilliant up, and it just works out great. I started playing the number 14, Greedy Saramea, because Trickstars are a thing, and this, like, you know, beats Trickstars. You make this, it's just 2 level 5s. It beats Trickstars because it says, your opponent takes any damage you would have taken from their card effects instead, and it's a condition. It's really good. And then this other effect is, when this card destroys an opponent's monster by battle and sends it to the graveyard, you can detach one Xyz material from this card. Destroy all monsters in the field whose current attack is less than or equal to the original attack of the destroyed monster in the graveyard. Very good effect, plus the 2500 attack on this guy is not terrible at all. And then for the last Xyz monster, I am playing the Sylvan Princess Sprite. Yes, I am playing this card, and the reason why is because this card, I'll show you guys in the combos exactly what I'm talking about, even if I have to, like, force hands and show you guys what I'm talking about, this card gets you there. And the reason why is because your cosmic compasses are ones, and like there's so many times where like you'll have a cosmic compass and you'll be going second and stuff, and you're just like trying to make boards, and you like you'll machine dupe on the cosmic compass and you'll be able to make a sprite, you know what I mean? And then like that spell you see on the top of your deck will be a brilliant fusion or an instant fusion or just something that like, you know, fixes your hand and you just go, you know what I mean? Or at the very least being able to like, you know, mill. There's been a couple times where I've like activated this card and it wasn't a spell, but it was a cyber dragon, and I'd have the repair plant in hand and then just activated repair plant and went off that way. Like this card just finishes, like it just gets you there. Like the way I explain this card, the way I was trying to explain this card to somebody in the deck is, it's like, okay, remember the Herald deck I showed you guys? It's like the Illuminite and Herald, where you pitch a card and draw a card. It's like that last, you know, that last ditch effort to get that card you need. This is that equivalent in this deck. Like, it's just that good. Along with Durendal. Durendal also, you know, fixes this. Like, I would say this fixes, you know, completely dead hands, you know what I mean? If you can at least make a rank 5, that is. And then this fixes, you know, hands that are just almost really broken. Like, this just, like, gets you there. But that's my opinion. I feel like, I actually really, really like this card. But anyway, so for the fusions, you play the Mega Fleet and the Fortress Dragon that I was talking about earlier. You know, you have to play the Fortress Dragon because this helps you extend if your opponent does have a Masterpiece out or whatever, because you just secure it and then summon a Cyber Dragon, and then bam, you know, you contact fuse into this thing. And then Mega Fleet Dragon, it's just such a good card. You summon out Cyber Dragon and out any extra deck monster. Oh my gosh, this is your out to just so many different things. Like between these two, you just out everything, and the kaijus, it's so good. Like main deck wise, this deck can out anything. it's just crazy. It's just being able to keep pushing after you do. That's the trick. But anyways, so you have the Panzer Dragon, which is your instant fusion target. I had to dumb this down to one instant fusion target to be able to add, like, so I was playing two instant fusion targets and then siding this, but gosh, like, so many people were playing Trickstars, and more people were gonna be playing Trickstars, so just like main deck this, you'll be glad, because you just win game ones against that dumb deck. So, yeah, like, play that. And if you guys, you know, are worried about this, it's fine. I actually am also back and forth about cutting Infinity to one, because I find myself only making one Infinity per game most of the time, or activating one. You know, you also only usually resolve one instant fusion per game either, so you can cut either one of these to one. Either way, it works, and the reason why it works is because let me show you guys something. So if you guys are worried about, you know, running out of you know, target, like running out of targets, you know, for your instant fusion because, you know, your Panzer Dragon's in the graveyard, you activate the second effect of Cyber Repair Plant, which says target one Light Machine monster in your graveyard, shuffle that target into the deck. So if you are that worried about it, you know, I kind of want to cut Infinity, but like I just can't will myself to. So instead, I cut the second Panzer Dragon. Shuffle it back into the deck, and then activate your instant fusion and bring it back out. Like, like that's really what it comes down to. Cyber Repair Plant is just a great card in Cyber Dragons in so many different ways. And there's been times where I've put Cyber Dragon back into the deck just to be able to machine dupe on a core and get it right back out. Like, it's pretty funny. But for the other fusion, you know, you have your Seraphonite for brilliant fusion, and that's your last fusion. For the Link monsters, you have your two Proxy Dragons because you need to. You have to play two in this deck. And then Decode Talker. It's just, I feel like I'm really, really happy with this extra deck lineup, except for sometimes I want two Panzers over, it just depends. Like, it really depends. Like, I really want to swap out an Infinity for a second Panzer, just because, like, Panzer Dragon doubles as your MST in this deck, because you can, like, instant fusion and, like, bring this out and then let it die off the instant and, like, MST something, or, like, you know, just pop something. That's really, really good. And on the flip side, I want to keep two Infinity, because there's a lot of times where I will have double Nova and an Infinity on one, because you can only slap, you know, one Infinity on one of these per turn. And then, like, they'll out one of these, but they won't be able to out the other one. And then, like, I'll just slap the second Infinity on it next turn and then take something. So, like, it can go both ways. You can see what I mean? Like, you can go both ways about playing, you know, two of these or two of the Infinity, but it's just player preference. At this point, I'm really on the fence about it. That's why I'm just gonna go ahead and be safe and play the two of this, because it makes the most sense to play just one, you know, instant fusion target and like double Infinity, because I find myself, you know, having two Novas on the board, but I find myself having like double Nova on the board a lot, but only making one Infinity. But like, I would rather have that second Infinity in the extra deck for the, you know what I mean? Does that make sense? I'm done with the extra deck now. Let's just put it that way. For the side deck, though, you have to have your field centers. Oh my gosh, fans have made me some of the coolest stuff. You guys have made me so much cool stuff. These two, like, cyber tokens are amazing. These field centers are amazing. Thank you guys so much again. It's just, oh my gosh, you guys are the best. But like, I mean, I was so, like, I can't tell you how excited I was to see these, like, you know, in the mail when I first got them, when I first got these, and when I first got these. They were just so cool. But anyways, to the side deck. So for the side deck, I'm playing this, just the Artifact Engine, but I'm also playing these, because, I mean, not only is this, like, part of the Artifact Engine, but, like, this, like, is your counter to evenly matched, and there's, like, a lot of people playing going second decks, maining evenly matched, you know, trying to be cheeky and stuff, and so being able to side for going first, and play Sanctums and all that, and really catch them off guard, I really, really like that. So you side out your Kaijus and stuff, and you put this stuff in, and it's just great. Basically, you cut out your odds and ends, for going second, side them out, and then put these in for going first, and it really trips up your opponent. It's really great. Keep in mind, these are all also, like, every single side deck monster, I try to keep light as well for Galaxy Soldier, because there's nothing worse. You know, I mean, it really sucks to have a Galaxy Soldier in hand and no light, so I always try to keep light monsters in the side. Speaking of light monsters, duh. So you have to play these. Dinko, Paleo, this wins against Paleo, plus you get two normal summons off of your Brilliant Fusion anyways, so that's really good. And then I like these. I've been really liking Honest lately, because it's like siding in. To me, like, siding in Honest like this is like siding in a main deck Lightning. Utopia the Lightning. Pretty much. There's nothing funnier than, you know, just having, like, a Cyber Dragon or something up, and then they attack you, and then dropping two of this. Like, it's really funny. But, you know, there's that. And then, you know, this just helps you get over stuff. I mean, like I was saying, like, this deck, you know, really, really gets over a lot of stuff. But then just to get over more stuff, Rageki Darkhold. This side deck is really interesting. I feel like the side deck's solid. Even the Honest, even though this is cute and stuff, you know, I feel like it's actually really good, because every time I've sided this in, I've liked it. Like, I've really, really liked it. And I sided this in Heralds too, and I liked to side it in Heralds as well. Plus, this is a fairy in Heralds, so you can technically search this in Herald. But yeah, light for Galaxy Soldier. I just really like this side deck a lot. You know, this, especially the Lancias, because, like, Lancia, I always side in Cyber Dragon. Maybe there may have been a format or two where I didn't, but, like, this is a level 5 light. I mean, you could tribute summon for it, and it you can go into Pleiades with it or whatever. It's a hand trap. I mean, and technically, if people are playing a lot of back row destruction, you could technically set this and, like, summon it, you know what I mean, when it's destroyed. So, like, that's really cool too, because, you know, after all, these are artifacts, so you can do that. But yeah, plus you can, you know, combo this with Sanctum, because it is an artifact. You can, like, you know, Sanctum this out, and then, like, you know, like, tribute it, your opponent can't, you know, banish cards. I just feel like this side deck's really solid, honestly. Like, the more I, like, look at this deck and stuff, the happier I am with it. But, of course, I'm always up for suggestions. If you guys just see anything, like, glaringly wrong with my deck that I'm missing, please let me know. But until I see those, and until I fix those mistakes, if there are any, let's get into the combos. Alright, so let's shuffle this really well, because everything was divided, you know, for the deck profile, monsters and spells, everything was all clumped together. So, let's shuffle this pretty well, cut that in half. Oh no, Brilliant Fusion on the bottom. That doesn't look good. Maybe we'll draw one though. Hey, we did draw one. That's pretty good. Hey, Animaxi. Hey! If this was a machine duplication, this would be really lit going first or second. But it's a Maxi. Let's just say, you know what? Let's just drop the Maxi. And let's just play this out, you know, how this is. Let's just try that out. So, Gofu, you summon out your Gofu, get out your two tokens, like so. And then, of course, you go into your, I'm like losing track of everything. So you go token, Proxy, and then Gofu, Proxy Dragon, and of course that makes Decode Talker. So you got out Decode Talker. Next, what you do is you go Brilliant Fusion, and you get out your Garnet and a Cyber Dragon. So there's Garnet. Oh wait, the Cyber Dragon. Sorry, where's the Garnet at? There it is. So Garnet and Cyber Dragon, and that's gonna summon out a Seraphonite. So there's a Seraphonite, and we have two normal summons, so that's pretty strong. So we're gonna go ahead and use normal summon number one. So normal summon number one, activate that effect, get out a Cyber Repair Plant, wherever that is, come on, Cyber Repair Plant, there it is. So Cyber Repair Plant, but you notice that we have two Cyber Repair Plants, so you can only activate one per turn. That kind of sucks, but it is what it is. We'll activate Cyber Repair Plant, get out, since we don't have a light in hand for Galaxy Soldier, which would be ideal, you wanna get out a Golden Jet. And what you wanna do from here is you want to go ahead and activate your Instant Fusion. So Instant Fusion, Instant Fusion is going to get out your Panzer Dragon. So Panzer Dragon. And then your normal summon your Golden Jet. So activate Golden Jet's effect, making it a level 5. Overlay these two. And you go into Nova. Activate Nova. And then get out that Cyber Dragon that you purposely pitched off the Brilliant Fusion. And then you overlay these two. And you go into Durandal. And wherever the Durandal went. Yeah, there it is. So there you go. So you have, oh yeah, then you slap an Infinity on the Nova. So bam, 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 bam. I was able to make that. And that was just without even the Max Seed. All right, what I want to show you guys now, I'll show you guys like a fun hand after this. But what I really want to show you guys is Cosmic Compass, okay? And let's not even open up that good. Let's just say Cosmic Compass, Instant Fusion. Let's just say like a weird hand, right? So like, I don't know, there. Then let's just say you're going second. So, you know, just put a Kaiju in hand. So this is a pretty weird hand, right? I mean, you're not seeing any of your Cyber Dragon monsters. I mean nothing. Like, you just have like a random, you know, random light in your hand. This is just like a kind of an awkward hand, right? You know what? Let's swap it for a Jizakiru. How about that? Let's swap it for a Jizakiru. Because that way, if this is like a Jizakiru, you can like out something your opponent has that's annoying you, or you could pitch this off a Galaxy Soldier. So let's just say you have like this kind of a weird hand. So this card can go either way. Let's just kind of leave it out for now, though. What I'm going to try to show you is how to play with the Cosmic Compass, okay? So with the Cosmic Compass, since you didn't open a Brilliant Fusion, what you're going to do is just normal summon it. Just summon it in like the zone behind, you know, the Link Zone. Let's just let's get out our Field Center. So here's our Field Center. And then let's just say you summon it here. So there you go. This is what is very important about Cosmic Compass in this deck. You never, ever, ever want to summon more than 3 tokens. I don't care if your opponent has 6 monsters, okay? You need to summon no more than 3 tokens ever, okay? unless you're playing firewalls and all that stuff. If you revamp this deck for Firewall Dragon and stuff, I don't care how many tokens you play, but since this is the build that does not play firewall, never more than 3. I only really ever do 2. So let's go ahead and summon out our 2 tokens. So here's our 2 tokens. Bam. And what you're going to do is, it's just what's really great about this is as you could already see, this is a 1 card anything you want. So let's just say it burnt up the normal summon, but that is just fine because between our 2 lights, like even if this was a Gamma Seal, you have a special summon and then like another special summon. Like, it doesn't matter that burnt up your normal. And plus, like this right here, even if your opponent's like, you can see this hand, like even if your opponent like ashes this machine dupe, which they probably will do because like they don't want you getting 2 more copies of this out of your deck and just like having all these monsters. Like, even if they ash this, you can see where you could still like special summon and be able to make a board. But so right here, let's just go machine duplication, get out 2 more copies of the Cosmic Compass. So Cosmic Compasses, bam, so 2 Cosmic Compasses, right? So you have these. And you can go into Mrs. Radiant if you have room for Mrs. Radiant. I had to cut Mrs. Radiant. There's like no room for it. So what you do is you go token, Proxy Dragon, and then use these two. So you go these two and go into that Decode Talker once again. And if you notice, once again, we're kind of like leaving out this card, but it is in your hand. So you technically have 4 cards in your hand. If you notice, we have 2 level 1s on the board now. so what makes this broken, and this is what I was trying to explain earlier, like, so this hand's like, it's pretty good, right? I mean, like, you can Galaxies, you have a rank 5 play, let's put it that way. You can rank 5 and you have another move, okay? But what would really, really break this, I'm gonna shuffle up really good so you guys know I'm not gonna force this. Hopefully this will be really epic and I'll rip like a Brilliant Fusion or something, but I doubt that's gonna happen. So let's cut that in half, and then let's go ahead and slap on the Sylvan Princess Sprite. So Princess Sprite, you activate Princess Sprite and then rip a spell. Woo! See, just like that. So this got you to a spell, right? It wasn't the ideal spell because you don't have a Cyber Dragon in the graveyard, but if this was a Brilliant Fusion, like I was saying, like you play 3 Brilliant Fusion, guys, 3 Brilliant Fusion. So chances are like you're gonna rip it, and like I've done it several times. But you could also, you know, I mean, either way, or if this was like a Desires, or if this was, I don't know, like if you had a repair plant in hand and, you know, you just ripped into a Foolish Burial. I mean, you see where I'm going with this, or if you ripped into a Soul Charge. I mean, just if you rip into like just a spell like that, this card just like, you know, sends you over the edge. But let's just say we did rip into that Brilliant Fusion, okay? Just for example purposes, okay? You can see where, you know, this is about to get really, really nutty, because you go Brilliant Fusion, and Brilliant Fusion send Core, and send the Garnet, wherever the Garnet is. So Garnet, And then that'll get out the Seraphonite. So Seraphonite. And then with this hand, what you do is you just, you know, activate on the Jizakiru. Or if this wasn't just, you know, if this was the Gamma Seal or whatever, it doesn't matter. But let's just say it was the Jizakiru, just to make it, you know, that much more nutty. Galaxy Soldier's effect, get out the other Galaxy Soldier. And then you just, I mean, just, you go. I just love this deck so much. I love it so much. So what you do here, go ahead and burn your other Normal Summon with the Seraphonite up. So Normal Summon this, activate this effect or whatever. Then it doesn't really matter what you do. All you need to do at this point is make a proxy dragon over here. That's really what you need to do. So let's just say you make the proxy dragon with these two. So you go those two into that of the proxy dragon, which is why you need to play a proxy dragon. Then what you do is you go instant fusion. So instant fusion into your Panzer Dragon, and then this will get you to your Nova. So you see how, like, if we had ripped the Brilliant Fusion, how this, you know, really made your hand nutty. Like, you can kind of see that now, I think. I hope you can see it anyways. And then, you know, you just get out this, because why not? And then you slap an Infinity on this. So you have, like, all these monsters on board. And I actually messed up right there, because if I would have thought ahead, you know, I'm trying to record and do this at the same time. If I was just, like, dueling, I would have done this. But what you do is you send the regular Cyber Dragon, and this would be a regular Cyber Dragon. So this would be an extra 2,100 instead of 400, and you still have a Galaxy Soldier in hand. So it's not terrible, guys. This card is actually pretty lit. All right, so now let's rig up something crazy. Let's go Brilliant Fusion, Instant Fusion, let's go Core, Machine Duplication. Let's just do the good old stuff. Let's just do those, and then let's just say we open up, we get really lucky and open up a Gofu on top of that. So, yeah, you can see, I mean, you can definitely see this hand now. Like, you can definitely see how this hand can, like, keep playing through stuff. Because it's like Gofu, oh, you gave a Gofu, you know, Brilliant Fusion, okay, so you Ash Brilliant Fusion, you still got moves, you know what I mean? Like, it just between everything, it's just being able to push and push and push and push. I just cannot say that enough. Okay, so you know, and even if you can't just keep pushing to make a board even through your opponent's hand traps, just at the very least getting them to burn those hand traps and stuff, and maybe having a move next turn, like trying to keep a move in your hand for next turn or whatever, that works too. Just whatever you can do to try to, you know, play through your opponent's crap. That's all I can really say. So with this hand, let's go Gofu, token, so token will fade off, and let's go you know, proxy dragon, and then these two will go away, and we'll go into decode. All right, so now from there, let's go Brilliant Fusion off of this. Let's send regular old, let's just say regular old Cyber Dragon, and then where's the Garnet? So there's the Garnet. All right, and then now get out your Seraphonite, bam. All right, and then Normal Summon number one. So Normal Summon number one will be for Core. Core will activate, getting a search for Cyber Repair Plant. So Cyber Repair Plant, and then what you'll do is activate that Machine Duplication. You guys have seen this several times now, but like, it's just these combos, they never get old. They're so sick, they never get old. You build big boards with them, and you get to play Cyber Dragons on top of that. It's just so much fun. And then, like, you know, going through these, it's like a walk in the park for me now. I've played this deck for so long, you know what I mean? So we're here. Actually, you wanna leave this open for Proxy Dragon, by the way. So what we're going to do from here, though, is go into Instant Fusion. Yeah, let's go ahead and Instant Fuse for Panzer Dragon. So there's Panzer Dragon. And then let's use a Cyber Repair Plant, because we do have a Cyber Dragon in the grave that we sent off of the Brilliant Fusion. So let's do a Cyber Repair Plant for... in this case, let's do Chronomaly Golden Jet. Yeah, that seems about right. So from here, we want to go into that. We obviously want to go into Proxy Dragon. So let's use these two, go into Proxy Dragon. So there's Proxy. And then what you want to do is Normal Summon number two for that. Activate that effect, make it a five. You can just overlay these two, though. So you go into Nova. So Nova number one. So Nova number one, activate, summon back out. And then you can slap an Infinity on that. Then go into, I guess, Nova number two. So let's go Nova number two. Activate, bring that back out, and then overlay these two. And you're gonna go ahead and overlay those two for either if you're playing against Trickstars, or Durendal. Most likely Durendal, because this will give you another negate. You'll have the Infinity negate, and then you'll have that Durendal play on this Brilliant Fusion on your opponent's turn. So that is how you play Cyber Dragons, guys. I mean, your hands will vary and stuff. I could sit here and show you guys how to play Cyber Dragon hands for hours, okay? Like, if you're that interested in, like, you know, in like, picking my brain about Cyber Dragons, guys, I do have a Patreon. I do have Patreon rewards, so check those out if you guys are interested in that. You know, and Skyping with me and talking Cyber Dragons with me for a long time. I'm always happy to talk with Cyber Dragons. You just gotta get me to make time. But yeah, guys, that is it for this deck. I really hope that you enjoyed it. I tried really, really hard to be able to make this as competitive as I could. I really tried. I made it to where, you know, for the most part, it doesn't really matter what hand you get. I mean, unless you, like I said earlier, just draw, you know, Garnet Double Brilliant, which just kind of happens. It does happen. I mean, just look at this, though. Like, going second, guys, I mean, I've just really tried to make it to where it doesn't matter what hand you get. You know what I mean? You can at least draw cards and or just, you know, make a board. Just be able to, you know, get Cyber Dragons out and, you know, that Nova out, that Infinity out, everything like that. I just try to make it to where this deck can do that every single turn. At the very, very least, be able to make an Infinity or be able to make a Durendal and then draw a better hand. You know, or at the very least, be able to, you know, make that Infinity or Durendal and at the same time, you know, burn... you know, a hand trap or two. That's the whole point of this deck, guys. I really, really hope that you enjoyed it. I hope that I explained everything adequately. If you guys are looking forward to playing this deck, you know, or maybe you bought the Legendary Dragon decks and you're interested in Cyber Dragons, I really hope that this helps you out. I really hope that, you know, you pick up the cards and give this deck a shot, or, you know, play on YGO Pro or Dueling Book or something like that. Give this deck a shot, because some of the combos with this deck can get really, really nutty. I mean, there's, like I said, I played this deck for so long. You know, all the, like, I just know, like, so many different combos and just weird angles and stuff with this deck. I could talk about it forever, and I mean, I could do a 4-hour long Cyber Dragon deck profile almost, I feel like, at this point. Like, I really, really could, because I just know so much about the deck. You could talk forever about, you know, different combos and different situations that have come up and weird things that I've done to be able to, you know, make moves and make boards and all that stuff. Once again, though, guys, I really hope that you enjoyed this. I hope that you guys have a Merry Christmas, and until next time, be sure to dick slap that like button and subscribe.
Subscribe.